just like to share 3 points from the three readings today. In a way, just to be able to give a little introduction about me, and hopefully I'll get a chance to get to know you, each one of you, little by little, I hope. So, my name is Father Carlos Jose Rojas, born in Boston, Massachusetts. It's a big day for this weekend, the 4th of July. I'm an Air Force grad. My dad is a retired colonel from the Air Force. Born in Boston, Massachusetts, in Lowell's Air Force Base. So in the spirit of the 4th of July, happy Independence Day to all of us. I am the only son of four. My mom, my dad, and there's four sisters. I'm the only boy. Four sisters. And I'm the only boy. And my younger sister, she's special need. She's 33. Looking for the best care for my sister, because we are as strong as the most vulnerable member of our family. In looking for doctors that specialize in her condition, that's how we ended up in the Tampa area. High school here, Chamberlain High School. I went to USF, and after my fourth year in college at USF, that's when I discerned the call to priesthood. And went to the seminary at St. John Vianney for bachelor's in philosophy, and then to Boynton Beach, and this is the Paul, Boynton Beach, for master's in divinity, and a second master's of arts in theology. Since I've been ordained for 16 years. I was ordained May 20, 2006, so this is my sweet 16 year. And it's a great honor. And starting with the second reading says, may I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. May I not boast of anything except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, where the world is crucified to me and I to the world. That's quite a powerful image. The cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. Somehow in the mystery of the cross, we are crucified to the world, and the world is crucified to us in the mystery of the cross. Something to ponder about. If anything, the past 60 years of my priesthood has been tough ones. After 16 years, this is my 9th assignment. Don't worry, it's not because I'm a bad priest or a troublemaker. Well, I am a troublemaker, but for good things. In many ways, I have a certain set of skills that help me really embrace the mystery of the cross, to which the world is crucified to me and I am crucified to the world. To embrace the cross, there's a beautiful image of St. Francis of Assisi embracing Christ. Christ embracing St. Francis of Assisi from the cross. In many ways, I draw out my spiritual strength from that mystery. Embracing the cross embracing me, in which I am embracing and crucified to the world crucified to me in the mystery of the cross. Many of the reasons why I got moved from parish to parish so quickly, I was able to discover a gift to help communities heal and to revive. That's been my gift as a priest, to heal communities that were broken and to revive them. Don't worry, I wasn't sent here because you need healing and you were broken or something. Although, of course, there's always healing and revival to do in any place that we are sent. I was actually sent here as a reward for all the hard work that I've done. After several parishes where it was one after another of just trouble parish, heal, revive. The bishop said, I think it's time for you to just settle down. And I quote the letter that the bishop sent me. It says, by virtue of this letter, I hereby appoint you to the office of pastor St. Rita Parish, Dade City, effectively July 1st. This appointment is for a term of 6 years. Renewable once. All rights and obligations as pastor vested on you starting on that date. So I served as a parochial administrator 3 times already, but it was go in, search and rescue, help, heal, revive. Okay, next one. Search and rescue, heal, rescue. But now this one is, you know what? No more parish administrator, go as a pastor. That's actually a great sign of the bishop. Speaks highly of you, you know, that a place where a priest who's worked so hard can go to heal, to recuperate, and to continue his ministry and to be appointed here. It says a lot about you, so I'm looking forward to meeting you. Typically, the bishop will appoint a priest as parochial administrator first for 1 year or two, like was the case of Father Pedro and Father Diane Machado. Usually they send them 1 or 2 years. They check out to see if there's chemistry. It's like a courtship. They're dating to see if there's if the match is there. And once the match is done, then okay, we'll install you as pastor. That's the typical process they follow. In this case, the bishop said, no, you're going straight as a pastor. So I'm really pleased. And therefore I echo the words of the gospel. You know, it's the gospel, how appropriate, to stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you. And then it says, whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you, cure the sick and say to them, the kingdom of God is at hand. The idea of really settling, it's what I really look forward to my time here, to be able to just settle. Now, I also know permanence is an illusion. Nothing in this world is permanent. I can die tomorrow. Nothing is permanent for sure. Everything is by the grace of God. But I do hope, as written by the letter, that at least I am kept here 6 years, renewable for another 6. What will happen? All I know is I will continue to embrace the cross, to which the world is crucified to me and I to the world. And I invite you to do so, to boast of nothing else but that great mystery of the cross. God reveals to us how much He loves us, willing to die out of love for us. With that, I finish quoting the first reading. Some people may be curious to see, well, what type of spirituality this priest has. You see, well, he mentions some friends, and maybe his Franciscan, or maybe his church, or maybe, well, I'm a diocesan priest, but if I were to add another category to define my spirituality, I'm definitely a Marian priest. My love for the Blessed Mother and her love for me. My name is Carlos Jose. So in many ways, I act in the person of St. Joseph, chaste spouse of Mary. I've given my heart to her, and she's given her heart to me. And that's actually the great secret, to be able to embrace the cross, knowing that although it's difficult, it's painful, and many things come our way, that discourages us and makes us feel like we're not able to stay any longer in that cross, embracing the cross. But the great secret is, if you look at the foot of the cross, there she is, with great love, with maternal love, with a smile, invigorating, saying, you can, my son, you can do this. And therefore, if you ask what's my spirituality, how appropriate that the first reading today. I have done so many holy hours with that scripture. This is Isaiah chapter 66, especially verse 12 to 13, especially the part that says, as a mother comforts her child, so will I comfort you. In Jerusalem, you will find your comfort. I hope that my time here could be that I become an instrument of that maternal love of Mary, and Mary who is the preferred instrument of the Father's maternal love. When He says, as a mother loves a child, so will I love you. And He says so, but He does so to the instrument of Mary. If anything, I hope that my time with you be an instrument of the Father's maternal love to you. As Mary and I work together, as we discern your needs, as we try our best to heal, to revive, to do whatever God asks me, but for sure, to settle, to be at peace, to be comforted by the Father, something that only happens if we truly embrace the mystery of the cross, to which the world